Say goodbye to those unsightly cracks and get ready to say hello to a silky smooth display. This guide will run you through the process of replacing your Galaxy S21 Plus screen. For this repair, you'll need an eye opener, a suction handle, iFixit opening picks, a Phillips 00 screwdriver, a spudger, isopropyl alcohol, ESD safe tweezers, and plastic cards. You'll also need adhesive for both your display and back panel to make sure your phone stays water resistant. One more tool we highly recommend is our magnetic mat. It helps you stay organized and you can write down notes during your repair. Before beginning any repair, make sure your battery is discharged to 25% or lower. A charged lithium-ion battery can catch fire or explode if you damage it. Before we dive in, it's worth noting that we'll be working on the S21 Plus model. The S21, S21 Plus, and S21 Ultra are all very similar in build, but the internals differ just enough that we'd recommend that you follow the individual guides for each device over on iFixit.com. With the phone switched off, we're going to apply the clear side of a hot eye opener to loosen the glue on the rear bottom edge of the phone. If you have a cracked back panel like ours and your suction cup isn't sticking, you can use clear packing tape to cover the cracked areas to help your suction cup. Grab your suction cup and apply it to the bottom edge and begin to pull until you see a small gap. Once you see a small gap, insert the tip of an opening pick so that the adhesive doesn't re-adhere. Slide the pick to the left corner, making sure you cut the adhesive and leave the pick in the corner. Then insert another pick and slide it towards the right corner. Be sure to leave the pick so the adhesive doesn't set. Repeat this same process on the right-hand side of the phone. We're going to cut through the top edge of the phone next. You'll find the area near the cameras is glued down pretty well. Finally, insert your pick on the left-hand side of the phone and cut away at the remaining glue. Be wary of ribbon cables and the camera lenses. You don't want to accidentally catch a cable or smudge the lens with a glue-covered pick. Now we can remove the back cover safely, and we're in! Insert the tip of an opening pick underneath the NFC antenna and charging coil assembly just above the loudspeaker and move it towards the bottom of the phone, slicing the adhesive to separate the assembly from the battery and loudspeaker. Use a spudger to disconnect the charging coil's cable from the board and then the NFC antenna cable. Grab your driver and remove the 5 Phillips screws from the motherboard bracket. With the screws removed, go ahead and use a pair of ESD safe tweezers to remove the NFC and charging coil assembly. Use your spudger again and disconnect the 5G antenna cable, and then the battery cable. Let's move on to removing the 6 Phillips screws securing the loudspeaker to the phone. With those screws removed, use an opening pick to lift the component out. Disconnect the display cable from the motherboard and daughterboard so you can remove the cable from the phone. Let's turn the phone over and apply heat to the left edge of the screen for at least 5 minutes to help loosen the glue holding it in place. Apply the eye opener just long enough so that the edges of the screen are uncomfortable to the touch. The adhesive on the display is extremely strong, so you may need to apply the eye opener several times before lifting the screen. Apply a suction cup to the left edge of the display and as close to the edge as possible. We actually flipped the orientation of the phone to make this process easier, but we are working on the left edge. Lift the screen until you see a gap big enough to insert a pick. Now slide the pick to the top left corner of the screen and leave the pick there to keep the display from resealing. Insert a second pick at the top left edge and slide it to the bottom of the phone, making sure to cut all the glue. Like before, leave the pick at the bottom left edge. Grab another pick and insert it at the top left edge to cut the adhesive along the top. Be sure not to insert the pick too far to avoid damaging the front-facing camera. Leave the pick on the top right edge. Make sure that you reheat your eye opener and reapply heat to the screen as necessary. Take another pick and insert it at the top right and work your way down to the bottom right edge. Leave the pick inserted. insert a fifth opening pick at the bottom right corner of the screen, and slide the opening pick along the bottom edge to slice the remaining adhesive. Now insert a plastic card into the gap between the frame and the right edge of the display. We need to cut through the adhesive under the midsection of the screen. Once you've cut through the glue, you can remove the display. Be sure to clean the old adhesive and apply new adhesive to your phone's frame. Check out our video walking you through the process of reinstalling display adhesive. This will ensure that your phone retains its water resistance. Once you have your replacement adhesive in place, lay the display over the adhesive without removing the adhesive liner and turn the phone over. Reconnect the display cable to the daughterboard and motherboard. Now would be a good time to connect the battery cable and power on the phone to see if it works. If it does, power off your phone and disconnect your battery. Then disconnect the display cable from the motherboard and daughterboard. Flip the phone over and remove the display carefully with a pick. And then remove the adhesive liner. Align the display over the phone's frame and slowly lower it in place. Once in place, press the display edges down to help the adhesive bond. Flip the phone over and reconnect the display cable to the daughterboard and motherboard again. Reinsert the loudspeaker and secure it in place with the 6 Phillips screws. Reconnect the 5G antenna cable and the battery cable to the motherboard. Realign the wireless assembly coil and its attached bracket, and reconnect the NFC antenna cable and the wireless charging coil cable. Screw back in the 5 Phillips screws, securing the bracket to the device. Ensure that the edges of the device are clean and free of any residual glue. Use isopropyl alcohol and a cloth to remove any residue. Make sure you apply adhesive to the rear cover if your replacement part didn't come with adhesive pre-installed. We have a video that shows you how to reapply adhesive to your Samsung's back cover. Peel away the plastic over the adhesive, align the rear cover with your phone, and place it gently in position. Run your fingers around the edge of the phone to ensure the adhesive makes contact with the frame. Lastly, add a couple of books or a box to apply pressure and make sure the adhesive bonds.